not that aren't here have a lot of obligations, but I still call their name. First, I want to give you a little highlight of our season. We were 14-2. We started off the season with two losses, then we won four in a row, then we lost two games, then we won the last 10. We had two highlights I want to talk about. On January the 9th, we played Hamilton. And it was a very tight game. The score was tied with, I think it was 5 seconds left. And we had an out-of-bounds play that was worked to perfection. Thank you, ladies. And Brianna hit a baseline jumper. And Hamilton didn't have any timeout. We act like we won the national championship. But it was great. It was a lot of fun. But to see the excitement in their bodies, it was great. It was good. And then the next week, we beat Mountain Point. At Mountain Point. I think we got cheated at our school when we played them.
Sir.
I agree. We were. So those are some highlights. Also, when we beat an undefeated Highland, we beat them at our school. We changed our defense, and that was the game that Lonnie Smith locked their best player up, and we ended up winning that game. And it was great to see them again, happy about that. In the beginning of the year, when you have freshmen coming, you don't know what you're going to get. Seriously. But we had 10 girls who were willing and able to function, listen to what I had to say, and then work for them and the team. At this point, I'm going to call them up. Number 2, Emerson Barrow. Emerson, unfortunately, her foot, she was a starter and she hurt her foot, but she came back toward the end of the year, ended up playing 3 games at the end, and we have great expectations for her next year, and we appreciate your work and effort. I want you to stand up for this and somebody else, so thank you. All right, number five, Maya Smith. Maya had to go to a cotillion, so she won't be here, but I'm gonna say something. Maya was our defensive stopper. She was one of the fastest players on the team, and we appreciate her effort. Number 12, McKenna Bryan. She was our sixth woman off the bench. She was the first guard off the bench. Whenever I called her name, all I had to do was look and say, "Ma," and she was gone in the game. We appreciate your work and your effort. Next person, Tyron Gleish. I always botch her name, I'm so sorry. Rebounders at her size that I've ever had the privilege to coach. A lot of fun, always smiling, pretty smile. She will be a good player for the school the next couple of years if she doesn't switch to lacrosse. I hope. Alright. Our next person is not here. Brianna Gardner. The general, the floor leader, came from Chicago, didn't want to play basketball because she didn't think anybody would like her because she came from another state. She came right in, took over, that was it. We really appreciate that. Next person, number 23, Kaylee Glossy. Has never met a jump shot she didn't like. It paid off for us. It didn't pay off for everybody else. She's very fast with the ball. She's going to be a great player for this school in the next couple of years. Next person, number 30, Mevani Hackney. Now, Mevani never played basketball. She played basketball in seventh grade. And then came to high school and wanted to play. And it was difficult for her at first, and then all of a sudden, I think one game, she came in and shot two baseline jumps. I said, what did I miss? This girl can play. So I expect that next year when you come. Okay? God bless you. We really appreciate your work. The next person, number 32, Simone Kirk Bowles. The light came on for Simone. I put her in the game. Said, Simone, you're going to start. She gave me that Simone look. Don't you get me? Get out. You're starting. And she scored the first 6 points. I said, okay, good. Now she has it. And again, another person I expect. Actually, as a matter of fact, the whole team I expect them to be playing JV next year. So Simone, if we can get her away from volleyball, she will be a great player for this school in the future. Next person, number 33, Ashlyn Connor. Ashlyn is going to be, this is my prediction, a McDonald's All-American. That may be kind of far-fetched, but I think she has the ability to get there. She played, she swang this year. What I mean by that, she played JV and freshman. And when she got into the freshman game, there was no play set up for her, but she acted like she'd been there the whole year. I expect great things out of her. Last person, last but not least, number 42, Erica. Erica is the mother of the team. She mothers everybody. There's never a dull moment when Erica is around. Everybody is cute, everybody is sweet. We love Erica. Erica did, I think it's Erica, I think it was you. And she made a comment that said, Coach, can we pray before games? I said, wow, I never had a player say that. And we did. And it was great. The whole team gathered around that act. But the thing that we had to watch out for, I said, well, you know, I can't initiate this. So if you all say we can do it, we can do it. And they did it every game. And when we won the game, they had a little cheer in the back, not gonna say, but it was great for us. And another good thing about them, there was no drama with this group. None.